All right, getting parenting advice has changed in so many ways. A lot of us look to blogs for help, for advice, but things can get a little tricky, though, with depending on what you're looking to ask.
I think there are thousands of those mommy blogs out there, and I think I read all of them during the first
three months. There are daddy blogs, too. Yep.
There's a lot out there. If you have any questions like potty training, how to get your kids to brush their teeth, or in my case, how to get them to sleep, the internet is a great place to go to find success stories, but those success stories also are becoming success stories in their own right. Mommy blogs that started as online conversations between new parents are now a multi-billion dollar industry, and today, moms from all over the country are going to be flocking here to Austin for an annual conference called Mom 2.0. And Katie's joining us.
That is right. Good morning. And so for a lot of people, gone are the days. Not everyone, because I know you and Mandy told me that you guys bought some books. But for most people, gone are those.
I'm a mommy blog fan. I love it. It's where you go to get advice. It's not medical advice. It's just like community support.
Well, some of them do medical. They're like, hey, what is this rash on my child? But So for some, gone are the days that they're going into the bookstore and they're coming out with a big stack of parenting books. Now they're turning to these mommy blogs, to social media for information. And today, about 1,000 moms who create content online will gather at the Mom 2.0 Summit to share ideas and take a look at the upcoming trends. Many of these moms focus their content on parenting. Jennifer Bourget is one of those moms. She lives in the Austin area and has amassed thousands of followers online through her blog, Cherish 365. Bourget says she started blogging 10 years ago before she was even a mom. Now the mom of three says the experience of being online has made a difference, not just for other moms, but for her as well.
I think we have so much information at our fingertips, and though books are still great resources, sometimes it's nice just to hear from people that you can relate to more, not necessarily experts, but people who are down in the nitty-gritty, like going through it right alongside you. And it's just so easy to access it from our pockets, you know, on our phones.
And for many moms, this is also a source of income.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Speaking with Bourget, she says she knows moms who make millions for sponsored content. Now she adds, moms interested in jumping into the blogging world should do it because everyone brings a different perspective to the table. And I know, John, you were telling me that those different perspectives kind of made you a little.
You can overdo it, like with reading the blogs, because I got to a point where I was like reading so much conflicting information that I was like, all right, fine, I need to stop. Like, she's either going to sleep
or
she's not.
No, everybody's different. You go for support.
Yeah.
You know?
Yes.
And yes, if you have a question about a kid's rash or something, you go for support and then you talk to your doctor. Jennifer, used to be a news anchor.
Yes, she was. She used to be
I think she's making a little bit more now, right?
Yeah. There you go.
There is something nice and nothing else knowing this. Other people are going through this as well, that it's not just us struggling with the baby or whatever.
Who knows? Maybe one day I'll be a mommy blog.
Oh, there's but it's happening today, right?
The summit starts today and it goes through Friday. Unfortunately, this year tickets are sold out, but dads will be there as well, too.
So you can come babysit my two kids.
Yeah, you can come by.
And we'll talk about how you can start your own blog.
There you go.
Thanks, guys.